What do you think, Dick? New competition, same success? Let's hope so, because the loser gets to watch from the stands after this third-round game between the Bradley Braves and the USC Trojans.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Trojans should be able to put this team away early, Dick. What's the key to them doing that tonight?
Hey, Brad, for them tonight, the keys are as follows. First, reward your big men for running the court. Get them some easy buckets in transition. Secondly, you can't win, baby, if you don't get the glass. You must rebound. Rebounding is the key. And lastly, don't get away from what got you here on defense. Don't try and do too much defensively.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. From three-point land. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Both teams looking to get things going here.
He's got to pass it or make a play, Brad.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He puts up the tray. Oh, yes.
Roll it back again, fellas.
They're working around the arc. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He makes a nice shot fake.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Defense giving some room. He throws it up from downtown. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Fed the low block. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. For two. Perfectly executed. Gave it up. Looks at a three. Off the rim and no good. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Looking for contact. Up and in. Working around the perimeter. Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you what, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it. Coming inside.
Number 20 handles the feed. Way off target. He'll regroup the offense. They work the perimeter. He up fakes.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
He's got to pass those off, Dick.
He doesn't trust his teammates, Brad.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Inside. For the bucket.
I love this guy, Hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. And yeah, why don't more guys use him?
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. The Braves have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
He takes the shot off the baseline.
Here's another look at the play.
Number 13 receives the pass. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Number 22. Makes a great move to draw the foul. This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Sinks it. Both free throws go. The center handles the pass. And they come with a double team to stop it. Launches a three. He hits the shot. Trying to pack it in and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Inside. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go. Looking for a good shot. Leans in. He puts it in with contact and all. On the low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying in film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
And in and out. And he scores despite the hat. The center receives the ball. I can't believe there wasn't a whistle on that one.
Yeah, it should have been a whistle right there. I thought there was definitely an offensive charge.
On the inside. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Turnovers either. Look at that spacing.
He launches the bomb, scorches the net.
They scored seven in a row.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Off the rim and no good.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Doesn't go. There's a bad pass right to the defender. For two.
Screen was there, but the shot didn't fall.
The Trojans are actually known more for their success on the football field more than anything else.
Hey, their football team is great, but their basketball program is starting to turn some heads.
And work it into a double team on the post. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He goes to the line for the first time. He hits his first. USC on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
Misses the second shot. Boards it.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
He shoots from right of the circle. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby. There's the trap.
He bombs from outside. Way off target. Boy, terrible execution on offense. He puts up the three ball. He makes the shot. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
Thanks, Aaron. And a momentary look from three-point land.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
On the dribble, gives it up. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Puts up the tray. He nails the bucket. Fakes the shot. That one, there should have been a foul call, I think.
Well, you take a look right there. I thought there was contact grab on the defensive player.
The Trojans will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. He was guarding him tightly, and then he went for the steal. An unsuccessful attempt resulting in a personal foul.
If you get the steal, you're a hero. But you always run the risk of committing a foul when you go for that steal.
On the outside, from three-point territory, no.
Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball with a deck. Where's he going?
He puts it up. That's good.
Look at this last play right here. Gotta take some pride on a defensive end.
He's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He goes with a jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Number 22 is fired up right now, emotional.
Hey, can you blame him, Red? He's getting it done.
Now the high screen. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Off the mark with that shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me? Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
Misses them both. Rebound.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
For the bucket, in and out. They just can't find the open seams on the floor.
They're struggling to score right now. Look at this, Mr. Nesla. He has a little something for the opposition. That, to me, is a no-no.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Executes the baby hook. Bradley have gotten themselves into a bit of a rhythm on offense, Dick. They're really on a nice run right here.
Up and inside.
Jumps in, and he scores it off the glass. Launches away. He hits the tough shot.
I'll tell you, he's knocking him down with ease, Brad.
The Trojans have a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
Here's a double team. He lets it go.
Shot didn't fall in, but it was a great use of the screen.
Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in man.
Goes up for two. Off the rim and no good. Number 20 is emotionally fired up.
And you know what, Brad? I'm excited for him. He's putting on a performance.
Drains the shot. This is getting ugly.
Hey, if you can't check your man, it's up to the coach to recognize that and make an adjustment.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Let's see if they go two for one here, Dick. Gave it up. On the dribble, gives it up. Number 14 with the fake. Seconds to get a shot off. Way off target. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Trying to draw the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Off the rim and no good. At halftime, the Braves are up by four. It's been a tight battle so far, Dick. Do you have a highlight of the half in your book?
Watch here. Having the ball inside like you see. And this highlight will take a lot out of a team on defense. I expect to see more of the same from both teams in the second half.
Second half about to get underway. Let's go down to the action. USC seemed to have just unraveled from the field there.
What a terrible shooting display out there. I mean, it was horrible. Everything about their offense was terrible, if you ask me.
Basket falls despite the contact. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Bounces off.
Nice fake.
Go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Gave it up. Jumps into the defender. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Gets it to go. On the dribble, gives it up.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish a good tempo.
The post flashes up high if he wants it. The point guard gets the pass.
Man, he ran his man right into the screen to get off that nice jumper.
For the deuce.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Pump fakes. He shoots. He gets the bucket. Looking for a good shot. Looking for a good shot. They've left him completely alone. He shoots from the baseline. Tickles a twine.
Look at that spacing.
For two. Finger roll. Number 22. Basket's good and the foul.
That's a big play. He was there when they needed him, baby. Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
Working around the perimeter. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you're fronting.
The center with the ball. He lets it go. Way off target. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Number 24 is whistled for the foul. Second personal foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Out there, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game. Great play to take that to the basket. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The point guard takes the feed. He shoots from downtown. He takes the rebound. Away the pass for the bucket. Bradley are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they've started to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question. Up and inside.
In the post. And the slam. Takes the pass in the paint. Tries to get the D to bite. For two, the layup. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action. it inside.
Trying to draw some contact. They still don't score.
Hey, as a coach, you really like to see your kids get up and challenge shots like that.
A lot of times, a challenge is enough to make the offensive player change their shot in the air. High post flashes. He gets the rejection. The ball goes out of bounds.
The momentum is on their side. High fives, chest bumps. We're seeing it all now.
They're definitely having some fun out there.
He tries to knock down the three. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Top of the circle, they're working around the perimeter. And off the mark. He attempts a jumper.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
From right of the circle, he drains it. Puts it up there. Buried it. Number 22 is charged with the foul. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat. The message from the bench, defensive stops and do it now.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Cue up the replay, fellas.
He intercepts it. They'll work it around the arc. Sets a screen for his teammate. He takes the shot from the baseline. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And the ball goes out of bounds. For the deuce. And he missed. On the dribble, gives it up. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Gave it up. He attempts the three. Gets it to fall. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
The Braves are ahead by eight. On the dribble, gives it up. Trying to stay with him defensively, and he's going to pick up the foul.
Oh, what a perfect job exploding their basket. Poor job defensively letting him get the ball that deep.
Time to pick up the defense here now. He pulls down the board. Working around the perimeter, fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind me because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect. So they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us. I'll tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
He unloads a three. Rims out. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Picked off. The shooting guard takes the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. The center gets the ball. Got it.
Take a look right here. He explodes to the basket.
The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. Close games that can easily go down to the final second.
Now they work it around the perimeter. The shot from the baseline.
Oh, you gotta knock those down. Great screen, but no go.
He goes for three. He gets it to fall.
Let's go to the instant replay camera.
Kicks it out. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Questionable shot selection there.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
They work the perimeter. That's a nice fake. He shoots from left of the circle. He gets another shot off and in.
And this show's about to start, Brad.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the key. Buried it. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. They move it into the front court. For the bucket. Up. Easy one. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
He sinks them both. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Front to take it away. Is this defense ever quick to recover?
It's core conditioning, Brad.
The ball goes out of play. Number 54 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
High post player flashing. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Steal.
He brought the ball back down to the floor and he stripped him.
He drains the shot. Controlling the ball. Gave it up. for two. He's not letting the game come to him at all.
Yeah, Brad, he's trying too hard to build a one-man show. He's taking the game away from his other teammates. Come on, man, get with the team, get in the flow.
The Trojans call a timeout, and let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Aaron's right about that. Count the dunk, and he goes to the line after being hacked in the air.
He took a beating that time, Brad. Wow, what finish.
Free throw line. Gets it. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either. STOP, this place will be off the charts if they can get a stop here, Brad.
Picked out of the air. I'll tell you what, with a score, this crowd is going to go nuts, Dick. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. He puts it in with contact and all. Two-point game. Three. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
On the dribble, gives it up, fakes a jumper. I gotta be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick.
I tell you, it's time to start fouling in order to stop the clock.
And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
There's the turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
This time, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad. It's a two-point game. The fans are going to make it even tougher, Brad.
You didn't expect him to quiet down, did you, Dick? He tries the three ball.
They have to foul to send them to the line and hope they miss.
And there's a look at the foul situation so far.
Hey, knowing when to foul and when not to foul is a great skill to have. Coaches should always be communicating this with their team. I tell you, what an opportunity he's got right here. Because to me, this is a gift.
Hits the second shot.
This is where you really need a bucket to have a chance.
It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you gotta think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
He tries the three. Off the rim and no good. With the layup. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Well, Mr. Vitale, there's the foul situation so far.
Hey, Brad, staying out of foul trouble down the stretch of any game is vital. You want to keep your opponents off the free throw line and out of bonus situations.
Makes it. Makes the second shot.
I'm out.
The player's got a much-needed breather with that timeout. With the long bomb. Off the mark with a shot. Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, I'll tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Trojans just wanted it a little bit more in this game, and because of that, they're going to live to play another day, Dick.
Hey, they're on their way to the Elite Eight, Mr. Nestler, where they'll be joined by the 7 best teams in the nation.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler saying so long.